Stay away from the major scenes. Ignore the whispers of a shattered on Lord. Have mercy on our soul. On Lord. Have mercy on our soul. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In today's session, we are talking about one of the important stations of the heart. This is a station of awakening. When a person is sleeping and he is actually having a dream and his sleep is very deep, and then some of his friends starting lightening the lamp, turning the light on, and start moving him, so he starts to wake up. He starts to open his eyes to see light, and sometimes he's amazed to see some other place that he is in, so he feels that he is a little bit strange. This is a station of vigilance. A person becomes awake, becomes vigilant, because he recognizes on that station that he is created for a purpose. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him to be straight on that purpose. And he has a goal to achieve, which is attaining the Jannah and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he starts actually to change. He starts actually to turn right and left, and to see himself and try to fix himself. And one of the important things on that station is that he recognizes how unworthy the worldly life is. He would actually recognize, and this is one of the most important steps, how this life is trifled, how this life is unworthy. And this is called Darul Ghurur. This is abode, or this is the home of deception, because most of people are deceived of this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Ya ayyuha an-nasu inna wa'dallahi haqq, inna wa'dallahi haqq, fala taghurrannakumul hayatud dunya. فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. O mankind, indeed the promise of Allah is the truth. So let not the worldly life delude you, and be not deceived about Allah by the deceivers. So a lot of people, they are deceived about the hereafter, and they don't exceed or extend their knowledge about the life in the grave and life in the hereafter, and how they are going to face a lot of atrocities. When someone actually was in front of Abdullah ibn Mubarak, one of the followers and the second generation after the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the man saying, "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un," we belong to Allah, and to Allah is the ultimate return. So Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak asked the man, "Do you know the meaning of this, of inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un?" He said, "Yes, it means that all of us are slaves of Allah, and definitely we are going to return back to Him one day." And actually, Abdullah ibn Mubarak asked him before that, and he said, "How old are you?" The man said, "I am 60 years old." He said, "60 years old? Since 60 years you are walking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, immediately you are going to reach your destination." Because everybody doesn't recognize when he is older for just 1 year, it means that he draws himself a step closer to his Lord. And he is covering a distance from the road that he is taking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the man said, "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." Abdullah ibn Mubarak asked him, "Do you know the meaning of inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un?" He said, "Yes, it means that all of us are slaves of Allah, and to Him we are going to return." He said, whoever knows that he is a slave of Allah and he is going to return to him one day should know that he is going to be questioned. And whoever knows that he is going to be questioned must prepare an answer for this question. So the man asked him, وَمَا الْحِيلَةُ? So what should he do? The man became old, and this is the situation of a lot of us. When he becomes old and he did not make progress, he did not make a significant step in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, should he feel despaired or frustrated or something like this? No, he mustn't actually give up hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Abdullah ibn Mubarak said, fix what remains, Allah is going to forgive what passed. So fix what is remaining in the future, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive what is in the past. Life is a big dream, and a person wakes up of this dream when he leaves it. Allah said in the Quran, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ. Multiplication in money, in wealth, in health, in children, in families, has actually turned and distracted your attention. Alhaakum, it preoccupied your minds. Hatta zurtumul maqabir, until you visited the graves. This is the visit which is mentioned in Surah Al-Takathur, is not a normal visit. It is actually a final and maybe the first visit. It is the visit which a person is not carrying. It is a visit where you are being carried on your coffin and people are putting you and putting the dirt or the dust in front of you, and then leaving you. All kings and all rulers, all monarchs and knights and courageous people and politicians, healthy and wealthy people all over the world, they experienced that, and they have drank from that cup, same cup, the cup of death, and they left everything behind them, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the inheritor, is the one who would inherit everything on the face of the earth. Inna nahnu narithu al-arda wa man 'alayha. We are the one to inherit the earth and what is included in it. Allah will inherit even the clothes that you wear. He will inherit everything. Wa laqad ji'tumuna furada kama khalaqnakum. You are going to come in front of us isolated, single, as alone, stand alone, as you have been created at the beginning. Even if people who were circumcised in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect them uncircumcised. يُبْعَثُ النَّاسُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ حُفَاتًا عُرَاتًا غُرْلًا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that people will be resurrected on the day of judgment, barefooted, naked, and they are uncircumcised. So Aisha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about that. And she said, O Messenger of Allah, men would look at women and women would look at men. He says, may Allah forgive you, O mother of the believers. The matter is so great. The matter is so tremendous and catastrophic. Ya ayyuha an-nasu ittaqu rabbakum. O people, fear Allah. اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. The earthquake of the day of judgment is something great. يوم ترونها, when you see it, تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت. A nursing lady will leave its baby, and every pregnant woman will have a miscarriage, will miscarriage its baby, and you will feel the people like drunkard. They are not drunkard. But the punishment of Allah is severe. When a person understands those meanings and he reads in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the example of this life and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it an example in the Quran in surah number 10, ayah number 24, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا إِنْ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. The example of this worldly life is but like rain, which we have sent down from the sky. فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ, that the plants of the earth absorb, those from which men and livestock eat until when the earth has taken its adornment and is beautified and the people recognize that they have full control of it, it our command strikes it a day or a night. أتاها أمرنا ليلا أو نهارا فجعلناها and then we will make it like as a harvest as if it had not flourished yesterday. كأن لم تغنى بالأمس. These are examples that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drives for people who understand, for people who ponder over. And the people who are mostly deceived by this world are the disbelievers. Because they think that everything which is in this life, this is the end. They are going to devour and to invest and to take every single pleasure and desire and whim that they would actually take in this life without any differentiation between what is halal and what's haram, what's prohibited and what is forbidden. And they actually devouring and going in all directions, misled, misguided by their whims and desires. But at the end, they are ultimately deceived by all of those actions and all of those things. يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدِّنَّ. They just know the superficial meaning of this life, which it goes up to this and it doesn't exceed into a hereafter. So they don't work for the hereafter. They don't work for their prosperity and eternity in their life to come. But they just work it for this life and they were satisfied with whatever pleasure that they drive therein. And also, this life is like a breath that a person takes. And this breath is gone easily. And this is what we will talk about after having, inshallah, a short break and we will be back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Stay away from the maleficent, ignore the whispers of the shayateen.
Explore the wisdom and balance of Islamic law. And the genius of Muslim jurists who distilled the essence of the law. Into short statements of potent meaning. So join me, Riyaz Ansari, for a survey of Islamic legal maxims.
Appreciate the accountability of Islamic laws against all manner of corrupt practices in Islamic legal maxims with Riyaz Ansari tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 11:30 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV.
We are not addicted to dawah. Addiction implies a short-term fix. One doesn't need to get into the zone to talk about Islam. You do dawah because it is a natural result of your commitment to Allah. If you don't talk, people are going to walk. The most effective combination in the propagation of true Islam is found in Dawah Ilallah. Join me, Arif Islam, as we go through Dawah Ilallah only on Peace TV.
Follow the tips to make the task of Dawah result-oriented in Dawah Ilallah next on Peace TV.
Stay away from the maleficent, ignore the whispers of the shayateen.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So the life and its deception is like a breath, very short, and a person will actually wake up from that breath or that dream in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are some reasons that people are deceived because of this life. Number one, or in the top of them, lack of proper knowledge, and also lack of certainty in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the six articles of faith that you have a belief and certainty in hereafter, in the life to come, and resurrection. So people, when they have a lack of faith, a lack of strong certainty in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and deception in this life, they think that they can live longer. They still have enough time to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They still have long hope. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that son of Adam brings older and two things become older in him. Number one, love of this dunya and love actually to get more. So he is attached to this dunya. This is a very exciting and this is very great problem that a person actually get. One of the reasons a person is deceived, he lacks insight and wisdom and a sense of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a light that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala casts in the heart of the believers. So most of the people, what they do is it just they sell the hereafter and they buy the temporary life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described on the day of judgment, one of its names is يَوْمُ التَّغَابُن. What is the meaning of التَّغَابُن? التَّغَابُن is taken from the word غَبَنَة. غَبَنَة means to fraud. When a person who experiences fraud in his trade or in commerce, is a person who actually sells or buys the merchandise for a very high price, or he sells it for a very low price. So there is fraud in the transaction. So the day of judgment is called يَوْمُ التَّغَابُن, the day of fraud. Why? The scholars said that it is a day of تَغَابُن because the believers and the disbelievers will think that they have been deceived in this life. Why? Because the disbelievers, they will find actually themselves nude of the paradise and they just cast in the hellfire. And so he will have to blame himself because he would think, how did I spend all of my life running after this dunya and these vanities and I couldn't get an eternal life like the believers? So he'll feel that he frauded himself, he deceived himself. And the believer would actually feel that he is deceived because he could not get higher ranks in the garden of paradise because the distance between each rank is like what is between the heavens and the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared a lot of grades just for the fighters in the cause of Allah. What you can imagine of other people. So it is a day of تغابن, a day of reception. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that's why the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam understood that meaning very deeply. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Umar ibn Khattab saw him and the straws of the mat was actually having traces on his skin, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, why? He said, because I saw the kings and knights actually are enjoying the enjoyments of this life and you are the best of humankind. You are the messenger of Allah. You are Rasulullah. And you are experiencing this hard and coarse act or coarse experience in this life or coarse life. Why? So the Prophet ﷺ looked at him and said, Ya Umar, are you pleased that we have this dunya, this life, and we have the hereafter? And they would enjoy this life. This life is theirs. But still we have the hereafter of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mali walid dunya. The Prophet ﷺ is saying, Mali walid dunya. What is the matter with the dunya? How the dunya can approach me? I'm just like a rider who just took rest under a shade and is going to leave it immediately. You can imagine if a person is traveling and he is taking a shade under a tree, or he is traveling from a destination to another and he is stopping in one of the bus stations or the railway stations and he is just taking rest and then he is going to return back to the train, or he is actually leaving the train because he reached already his destination. Is he concerned of taking the chairs and seats and lamps and things in the train? No, he is not concerned because he doesn't care. He is leaving that. This is an example of the life, and this is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood that meaning, and he compared it as like a shade. It's very short. It's the shade a person enjoys. A person actually likes to live in, but actually the sun is going very fast. So this shade is going to end. So this is life. That's why also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the food of the son of Adam and what he excretes is like dunya. It's like dunya. It's first it's tasty and nice, and afterwards it's dirty and it smells bad. So this is the example. And in a lot of ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gives us deep understanding and profound recognition of the true value of the dunya. And all of us, we remember the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that if it is worthy a wing of a mosquito, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't have given a disbeliever just a sip of water. He wouldn't given him a sip of water. But dunya is humiliated. It is worthless in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, it is not that precious thing that the people should actually fight about. And you find a lot of people, they are actually fighting each other, quarreling each other about houses and palaces and cars and money and wealth. And at the end, they just have meter in a meter, multiplying a meter just in the grave where they are prisoned over there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَاخْشَوْ يَوْمًا لَا يَجْزِي وَالِدٌ عَنْ وَلَدِهِ وَلَا مَوْلُودٌ هُوَ جَازٍ عَنْ وَالِدِهِ شَيْئًا. O mankind, fear your Lord and fear a day when a father will not avail a benefit for his son and a son will not avail a benefit for his father. إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. Definitely and certainly, the promise of Allah is the truth. So do not let this life deceive you. And don't be deceived about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the deceivers. So this is just a reminder that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends. So how to deal with this life? We are not supposed to abandon life because this is a planting place for the hereafter. Without life, you will not reach your destination. This is a crossing road by which you reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are not supposed to live life in mosques, secluded completely. No, we are supposed to face people and to face this world. We are supposed to put this life in our hands, not in our hearts. In the sense that we are not too much attached to that. That's why when Abu Hazim, one of the righteous scholars, was asked by one of the caliphs, why we don't like to move and migrate to the hereafter, and we like to live in this life forever? This is simply because you already established yourself well in this life. You built your palaces, you built your houses, which actually will live for thousands and hundreds of years, but you do not pay attention to building your graves, building righteous and good deeds in the hereafter. So you do not like to migrate from a wonderful place to a place where you will find a lot of torture and punishment in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Abu Hazim actually is a righteous scholar, and he was asked one day by Harun al-Rashid. And he said, Abu Hazim, do you need any help or any support from us? And Abu Hazim said, from you? He said, yes, if you need any help or any money or any houses, anything, I can give it to you. And he said, let me ask you a question, O Commander of the Faithful. And he said, what's it? He says, imagine that you are deprived of all water on the face of the earth, and you are just given the opportunity after having a deep thirst to just have this cup of water. How much you gonna spend for this cup of water? He said, I'm going to spend half of my kingdom. He said, half of your kingdom? Yes. He said, okay, so if you have already drank this sip of water or this cup of water, and then you need actually to urinate. But it is restrained, retained in your body, and you cannot get it out. How much you gonna pay to get rid of this water, to get rid of this cup of water that you have already drank? He said, I'm going to spend half of my kingdom. He said, oh, subhanallah, a kingdom which is not worthy of a cup of water or a cup of urine, and you ask me to ask you for something? I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gave you. That's why Harun al-Rashid asked the people to carry him to his grave. And he started shedding tears. And he said, oh Allah, the one having glory, have mercy on the one who is humiliating himself in front of you. You can't imagine all those kings, where are they? Where are those people who enjoyed and taken all the pleasures and joys of this life? They enjoyed everything and they got nothing. So this is one of the things, one of the reminders that the person when he receives, he gives up being more deceived about this life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide us with diligence and purification of our hearts and rectification of our intentions. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Stay away, stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayateens. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayateens. Oh Lord, have mercy, mercy on our souls. Oh Lord, have mercy.